Welcome back to the channel, everyone. This is Michael yet again, and I'm back to give my thoughts on a new movie. Now, this film came via Patreon request, and it's a film that I've never heard of, let alone seen, but it's entitled Smilla Jaspersen of Snow. Now, from time to time, you might see me glancing beyond the camera, and that's because I actually have the camera mounted on my computer PC, and I've got a page opened up on the movie itself. I know absolutely nothing about this film, and I want to make sure that I get some of the facts straight. Smilla Jaspersen of Snow. This is based upon a 1992 novel, which is entitled Miss Smilla's Feeling for Snow. I have never read the book, so I am not sure how true it is in terms of the film being to the novel. Now, the movie stars Julia Ormond, and from watching her performance in the film, I have vague memories of her in movies that I might have seen, one or two movies, but I can't recall those movies, so watching her perform here was like the first time I ever seen her. We also have Richard Harris and Gabriel Byrne. And before I begin, let me just say that this film is a murder mystery. So I won't be spoiling the movie, and I'll try to avoid things that may spoil the movie for those of you who haven't seen it. And I think there's probably a lot of you who haven't seen this movie, or like me, ever heard of it. So it's a murder mystery. And I'm going to give you the official synopsis of the film. Let's see. I got a touch screen here, but apparently it's not trying to work all the time. And then I'm using the mouse, and the mouse isn't trying to work all the time. But this is what it says. Police say otherwise, but scientist Smilla Jaspersen thinks her young neighbor was chased by an adult before he fell to his death. An Inuit who spent her childhood in Greenland, Smilla learns that the boy's father died while working for Dr. Andreas Torque, that's Richard Harris, in Greenland. After sharing her murder theory with an increasingly mysterious friend called the Mechanic, that's Gabriel Byrne, she heads back to Greenland in hope of finding a link between the deaths. So there you have it, guys. The film, you know, spends over 2 hours in its runtime, slowly building and discovering why and how this child died. And like I said, I don't want to spoil that for you. But in doing that, I can only give my opinion of the film and my reaction and my first thoughts. Now, I got to say, first and foremost, that Julia Ormond does an impeccable job as an actress in this film. She's pretty damn riveting. She turns in an exceptional performance. I really liked her. Now, granted, her character by nature in this film, she's, you know, and there's really no nicer way to say it, but she's a bitch. And I mean that in a really good way, if you understand what I mean. She's a bitch. She doesn't take anyone's shit. She says it like it is. She's very blunt and upfront. And as a character, that's pretty refreshing. I appreciate that because I've known people like that. So it's a true character trait for some people to be like that. And she's intelligent, she's witty, she's sharp, and she's smart. And apparently she's carrying quite a bit of baggage with her too. She's a pretty conflicted character. And I gotta say that from a writer's standpoint, she would be a really fascinating and rich character to write because she's so full of complexities. So I really appreciated her as a character. She's a really multi-dimensional character. There's a scene in the film, and I'm not trying to spoil anything. I mean, I don't think this would really count as a spoiler, but Smilla's father, and he has a wife, a young girl, either a wife or a girlfriend. But at any rate, Smilla doesn't get along with the young girl, and the young girl doesn't get along with Smilla. They argue and kind of trade jabs in the movie. And in one scene, it all comes to a head, and Smilla gets physical with her dad's wife or girlfriend. She grabs her by the neck, wants to shut her up, grabs her by the neck with her left hand, and then, you know, with the right hand, grabs her by the pussy. Where have I heard that before? Oh, anyway, she grabs her by the neck and grabs her by the pussy. And I mean, this is like a maneuver to shut the girl up. I mean, it works, but I'm thinking, where the fuck did that come from? I've never seen that in a movie where someone is trying to subdue somebody. They grab them by the neck and they just grip their fucking pussy. I mean, she was grabbing the girl's pussy like really hard. Shut her the fuck up too. That was a really kind of funny scene. I thought I would just throw that in, guys. Smilla, she was pretty kick-ass in this movie. Now, unfortunately, Richard Harris and Gabriel Byrne are pretty much left upon the wayside in terms of character development and writing. Richard Harris, who plays the so-called evil head of the mining corporation where the little boy's father worked, you see him a lot in the film, but he's only presented in scenes where he's in the distance for the most part. You see him talking, but you can't hear him. And surprisingly, there's very little time spent upon developing him as a character at all. He's really superficial, and as the villain in the film, for the most part, he's really left on the cutting room floor. You just don't really learn anything about this guy other than, you know, at the very end, why he's doing what he's doing. And as a character, you know, you see him react in certain situations and how he handles certain situations, and you just think that, why is he doing this? Is it that serious? So Richard Harris really suffers in terms of writing, and that's really sad considering how much time was spent on developing Smilla's character. Gabriel Byrne, who plays this almost dyslexic, this stuttering character who has a big part in the film, but at the same time, much of his time in the movie is spent where he's skulking around, kind of following Smilla. He's keeping an eye on her. We don't know from the way he's presented in the film if he's actually a caring character who has legitimate reason to be around Smilla. And he's just really mysterious. You don't really know what his motives are until the film unfolds even more. But he's there. We do learn things about him, but at the same time, he's not really too much developed either. I mean, he fares better than Richard Harris, but at the same time, he just doesn't get a really great treatment in terms of a character. He's ultimately there as a buffer for Smilla's character. We learn more about Smilla and her behavior through her interactions with Gabriel Byrne's character. So he's really there more for the benefit of her as a character, in my opinion, versus being there as a character for the film. Now, what can I say about the film itself without spoiling it? Well, the movie runs over 2 hours, and I've got to say, you know, the first half of the film is definitely the strongest because I was totally glued to the television set. I mean, you know, we had this little kid who's found dead. Apparently, he's fallen off a roof. And we have Smilla, who knows the child, and she also knows that he's afraid of heights and he wouldn't be up on top of a roof unless someone chased him there or forced him to be there. So the story itself in determining what happened to this little kid and watching her along the way is really interesting. And you see, at the very beginning of the film, the kid is already at his death, but we learn about their relationship through flashbacks and memories that Smilla had in experiencing with the child. And then we have Gabriel Byrne's character, the mechanic, who actually had an experience with the kid too. So he's, or at least the film presents the fact that he's close to the kid as well. Now, you know, I was invested in the film. I mean, we had a little kid, a cute little kid who, you know, fell upon possible corruption. And then we have Smilla, who loved the kid, and being as cold and indifferent sometimes and unapproachable as she was, she really cared about this kid. And I was pretty much, you know, locked in that relationship. I wanted the kid to have justice. I wanted Smilla to discover what happened to him and possibly grow as a character in terms of what she was doing. So I was very much glued to the tube in watching the first half of this film. Very, very interested, very, very riveting. I was hooked, guys. I was really enjoying watching this story unfold. And it just, I was just, you know, I couldn't turn my head. That's how interesting everything was. But, you know, when the film reached the halfway point and we learned a little bit more, things became less interesting. The second half is definitely weak compared to the first half, and it almost feels like it's a totally different film in terms of, you know, we have this mystery here, this low-key mystery that slowly unfolds, and then the second half, we pick up on a little bit more action, we pick up on things that seem to be taken from another film. And I don't want to ruin it for you, but the ending itself is totally kind of almost like out of left field. And it almost seems like it would be better in a film from the 1950s, a 1950s sci-fi film, because the ending just seems really out of left field, kind of strange. And I'll say it's kind of unsatisfying to me, because where the film was so smart in terms of writing in the first half, it literally, to me, falls apart in the second half. And honestly, with Richard Harris presented as the possible bad guy in the movie, his motivations and his actions in terms of leading his company and so on and so forth, you kind of look at the whole thing and you think, well, what did he really do that was that bad to begin with? I mean, his company found something. The boy did indeed, something did happen to the boy. And I can't really say what all happened without spoiling it, but it's almost a thing where you look at the situation and you say, well, you know, he really didn't do anything. He really didn't do anything that bad. So why is this person taking actions throughout earlier in the film to do what he's doing? Because it's really kind of unnecessary. I mean, we're not dealing with anything that really should be top secret. I mean, in terms of, you know, wanting to take people out and things of that nature. But I can't really go into it, guys, because it would ruin the story for you and those of you who haven't seen it. But if you have seen the film, maybe you know what I'm trying to hint on here. But I'll say that I really thought the film was excellent at the very beginning, the first half. But after that, I think that the film really failed. It really fell apart, and the ending is definitely not on par with how smart the film was at the very beginning. But, so overall, it was really hit and miss for me. It was disappointing. I expected really something better at the ending. I expected something really smart. I expected, you know, this kid's death to have a really deep meaning, but, once you hear what happened, you'll just be like, really? But anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. I appreciate it. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you in the very next video.